GaussView can set up and run a wide array of jobs. This video will describe each panel in the Gaussian calculation setup dialog. The keyword list that GaussView creates is displayed at the top of the dialog. It is constantly updated as you make selections in the dialog's various panels. Use the Calculate Gaussian calculation setup menu path to open the dialog. Pressing Ctrl-G, Command-G on the Mac will also open it. The Job Type panel is the first tab you will see after opening the Gaussian calculation setup. This panel has a drop-down menu with several job types. Here, we select Optimization, which performs a geometry optimization to locate a stationary point on the potential energy surface. The remainder of the panel contains options related to the selected job type. In this case, we see available options for geometry optimization. For example, this drop-down provides various options related to initial force constants. Here we select Read Cartesian to retrieve the force constants from a previous calculation at a lower level of theory from the checkpoint file. Note that the list in the drop-down menu is just a small subset of the capabilities offered by Gaussian. The blank option at the bottom of the list enables you to specify any job type keyword you like in the Additional Keywords field in the lower section of the dialog. For example, the dialog would look like this when specifying a Born-Oppenheimer molecular dynamics calculation. Many of the menus in the Gaussian calculation setup dialog include items like this one. Such items are typically labeled Custom or Other, and they usually require you to enter the desired item into the text field that appears. The Method panel specifies the model chemistry to be used in a calculation. The three pop-ups in this line specify the electronic state, ground state versus excited state, and if the latter, which excited state model to use. The theoretical method, and whether the calculation should be closed shell or open shell. For many selections on the second pop-up, the specific member of a family of methods will be selected via a fourth pop-up that will appear at the end of the line. The default model chemistry in GaussView is Hartree-Fock with a 3-2-1-G basis set. Here, we modify the method to DFT and select the APFD functional from the final pop-up menu. We also set the basis set to 6-3-1-1 plus G2DP. By default, GaussView assumes that the molecule has neutral charge and sets the spin multiplicity to the lowest value consistent with the number of electrons in the molecule. You will need to change these values when appropriate. The Title panel lets you create a brief description of the job. For example, the title can provide a description of the calculation and how it fits into its overall project. The title is an opportunity to leave notes for future reference. It will be displayed when you review the results of the job. The Link 0 panel is used for entering resource specifications and file details. These directives are described in detail in another video. This panel shows the GaussView default settings, which retain the checkpoint file after the job completes, giving it the same base name and folder location as the input file. Here, we specify the name of the checkpoint file from the previous lower-level calculation, step 1, using the %oldcheck link 0 directive. The General panel allows you to select common options that are valid for many calculation types. Here, we are going to turn on Additional Print, which provides more detailed output in the Gaussian log file. The Guess panel contains settings related to the initial guess. Here, we specify that the initial guess is to be read from the checkpoint file, rather than being computed at the beginning of the job. The Population panel allows you to specify parameters for the population analysis. It offers different options to the population keyword. Here, we request natural bond orbital NBO analysis for the molecule. Other options on this panel request that additional properties be computed, including orbital variations, such as natural transition orbitals and biorthogonalized orbitals. and other atomic charge schemes, such as electrostatic potential-derived charges. You can save the variant molecular orbitals in the checkpoint file instead of the canonical orbitals. You can also save computed charges as molecular mechanics charges for use in a future calculation. The PBC panel is used to set up calculations on periodic systems, such as polymers and crystals. The Solvation panel allows you to specify a solution phase calculation rather than the default gas phase calculation. The Model field allows you to specify a specific solvation model. We select Default, which is IEF PCM. Then we specify acetone as the solvent. The Preview panel displays a preview of the Gaussian input file that GaussView will create. The Additional Input panel allows you to include any input sections required by the keywords and options you have selected. For example, for an optical rotatory dispersion calculation, we would enter the list of incident light frequencies in this panel. Here are some important points about additional input. First, it is not necessary to specify additional input for job types that GaussView knows how to set up. For example, QST2 and QST3 transition structure optimizations, potential energy surface scans, and so on. These input sections will not appear in this panel, but you will see them in the Preview panel. Second, GaussView will separate the contents of the additional input panel from the rest of the generated input file with a blank line. However, any other required blank lines within the additional input must be included by you. Finally, this panel is used for additional input file sections only. Any custom and/or additional Gaussian keywords and options must be placed in the Additional Keywords field in the lower section of the dialog, not in this panel. The buttons at the bottom of the dialog can be used to run the calculation and to work with the generated input file. The Submit button will prompt you to save the input file and then submit it to Gaussian. The Quick Launch button will start the calculation immediately from a temporary file. The Edit button will give you the opportunity to save the generated input file and then open it in a text editor. The Retain button will close the calculation setup dialog while remembering all of its current settings. Should you later reopen the dialog, these settings will be restored. The Defaults button will reset all controls to their default values. Finally, the Cancel button will close the Gaussian calculation setup dialog without saving anything. For information about changing the default settings for the Gaussian calculation setup dialog and for defining calculation schemes, watch the video linked at the end of this video.